Hey guys, and welcome to Petrol Ped and to this week's midweek 180. Firstly, huge apologies for not doing one of these last week. I just basically ran out of time. I had too much content from Goodwood Revival to edit, and I then got invited to test drive the new Honda Civic Type R on the Wednesday, and by the time I'd filmed that and tried to edit it, I just ran out of time to do a midweek 180. Check out my Type R video if you haven't done so. And I know a few of you messaged me to say, where's the 180? Well, it's back again in full force this week. So if you haven't seen one of these before, the format is very, very simple. This is 180 seconds for me to give you my news, views, and information about upcoming reviews, all filmed in one take. And you will see that I've chosen the backdrop this week of the Caterham 620R. Now, if you follow my channel, you may well know that I picked up this on Thursday last week, and then on Friday my mate and Adam headed off to Wales to find the Black Mountain Road. Sadly, we only got as far as Bristol before a mechanical forced us to turn round and had the car recovered home, but it's quite a good film, check it out. I'll put the card above, but I picked this car back up today. This is actually Tuesday. I'm filming for tomorrow because I've got meetings in London tomorrow and I can't get some filming done. I've also decided that filming outside is a really bad idea because the flight path today from Goodwood, because of the wind, is right over my house. So any more planes come over, forget it. So anyway, let's get cracking without further ado. I shall start my timer. So, first comment last week was from Ginger17. Well done, mate. Let the battle royale commence. First comment, I will give you a shout out next week. And I'm going to say hi to Roger Pope, who is in Ashford. Roger, you always comment on videos, and it's such a shame we didn't get to meet at Revival, but maybe next year. Now, the question I asked last week was coupe or convertible, and the scores on the doors are in. Coupe won by an absolute mile, 14 votes to 6 in favour of coupe. I'm still in the convertible camp, though. I kind of knew that was going to be the case, if I'm honest. This week's question, based on what happened to me with this puppy on Friday, I want to know the worst place you have ever broken down or the worst breakdown story. Put your stories below and I will pick a couple out next week. I'm sure we've got some good ones out there. Clearly it was F1 this weekend from Singapore. I managed to watch all the qualifying and all the race because I wasn't filming. So I thought it was an interesting first corner. As a race fan, it was such a shame everybody went out. As a Hamilton fan, you know, it was perfect really for him, because I think they were going to struggle had that not happened. I do have to laugh at this tweet though from the Ferrari official Twitter account. I mean, what race were they watching when they're blaming Verstappen for that crash, really? So brilliant Hamilton win. Obviously the other news that broke this weekend was the whole kind of Honda leaving F1, well, not leaving F1, but leaving McLaren to tie it with Toro Rosso. McLaren getting a Renault powertrain and a driver swaps around, which I think is going to be really, really exciting. But the most exciting news was the Andy Palmer being interviewed on Sky Sports saying that potentially Aston Martin are going to come into F1 when the regulation changes for the engines come in a few years' time. That would be hugely brilliant. The big car news of the week was obviously this, the Mercedes Project One, €2.3 million. This is effectively a Formula One car with a road body on it. It just, the numbers sound, or certainly the numbers that have been released so far, over 1,000 horsepower. They've detuned the RPM down to 11,000 RPM redline, really? And it'll have over a sort of 1,000 horsepower ready in 2019. Stunning looking thing, I have to say. Then from my channel news, I guess the big thing is now I've got this back, we are off to VMAX 200 at Bruntingthorpe Airstrip next Saturday. So I drive this up on Friday and hopefully we're going to have some good times and some good videos at VMAX. I'll actually be running it hopefully as well. It'll be interesting to see what it can be put up against, because this thing, it does 62 miles an hour in first gear and it will do 0 to 60 miles an hour in 2.7 seconds onto 155 mile an hour top speed. It's a biblical car, this. I'm going to try hard to get a few films and reviews done this week, so keep them peeled for that. If I can, I'm going to get a review of this up by Friday. That will be my next film, but we'll kind of have to wait and see on that one. That is the end of my 3 minutes. Yeah, I'd planned a whole bunch of films around the weekend, but because I didn't have the car, my schedule's kind of been put back a bit, and I've got other things on this week as well. But I do hope that my film on Friday will be a review of the 620R, and then the VMAX film hopefully should be a really, really good one. So keep them peeled for that. Anyway, I'm going to sign off there. I hope you've enjoyed this one. I'm going to go off and have some more adventures in this absolute animal. Oh, and the other one as well. Lots of people said when I picked this up, can you still smell the bacon? There are still stains on the exhaust pipe from where the car throttle boys cook their breakfast on the exhaust pipe of this car. Interesting talking to the guys at Caterham about the mess they thought somebody had thrown up on the exhaust pipe. There was that much kind of burnt bacon and stuff, but it's all clean now. So yeah, hopefully lots of 620R content coming, but I will see you on the next video, guys. You take care, drive safe.